Hello and welcome to Ghost Engine DevVlog series. My name is Christian, your host, friend and coding buddy. In today's video I want to do an introduction and kick it off by setting up the project. Ghost Engine wants to be a game engine written in Rust. The plan is to accept multiple rendering backends, but for the time being I propose starting with OpenGL. On a stretch, supporting OpenGL first may give us the chance to try targeting web browsers much easier and faster in the future. The inspiration and determination to start on this journey comes from these guys. Raymond is working on his dream game. Thin Matrix published and is still working on his own games using his own engine. His tutorials and devlogs are a great knowledge source. The channel is working on its own game engine, but in C++, and his game engine series is a core learning material for me. Ghost Engine would not be an idea if not for Hazel Cherno's engine. Yon Yangset, I really hope I did not butcher his name. He's not doing game dev, but his streams about Rust advanced topics are a great resource when trying to learn and understanding the Rust way of doing things. I will leave links to their channels in the description below. The main reason I want to build the Ghost Engine is the learning experience itself. The second reason is that one day I want to say that code written by me is able to render a scene like the environment photograph used as a background for this presentation. I will leave a link in the description for this image. Also, I want a sense of ownership. I want to say this is my creation. Ghost Engine is my creation. About the learning experience, as I mentioned earlier, it has two points. One point it's it has to do with learning Rust for performance sensitive project, and the second target is to learn graphics programming. So that being said, let's go and set up the project. First, let's go and create the project on GitHub. Ghost Engine as a repository name, and for this one I don't know, I always liked when WordPress a new installation of WordPress had I think the page title or the page content, I think it was something like yet another WordPress blog. I'm curious if I remember correctly, but anyway, maybe it's not WordPress the thing I remember, maybe it's something else, but I will describe the project with something similar. Yet another Rust game engine. Okay, public. I want a README. I want a license. To be honest, I'm not really sure which license to use at the moment. But I want to stay fluid with the objective of this project and not always set things in stone. So for the moment, let's go with MIT. We may change this in the future. Who knows? For gitignore, I don't want any template for the gitignore file. I manage it by myself. Okay. Perfect. Now let's clone the code. For this, I'm using Sublime Merge. Okay. Ghost Engine projects, Ghost Engine, everything looks okay. Oh. Perfect. Now, when I'm working on a Git project, I know there is some debate about this, but I like using the Git flow branching strategy. So that's why I will initialize Git flow. Okay. So basically, what Git flow proposes, it's something like this. The master branch should be always deployable in production. On develop, we are working on the next release. On featured branches, we are creating them from develop, and there we work for a particular feature, maybe something bigger. Okay, the hotfix or bug branches are problems, mostly problems that are coming from production. We start the branch from master. We fix the problem in a hotfix branch. After we test it and everything it's okay, we merge the hotfix branch both in master and develop. There are a few more things to say about Git flow, but I think that's really nice, quick and easy introduction to it. But again, as I said, we are like water. We know what we want. We want to be able at some point to render a 3D scene similar with the real life image I've shown earlier. How we go there, it's not something set in stone. Good. Now, we initialize the project. Now, let's go and create two Rust projects. So, let me bring to front my development setup. Okay, I have Ghost Engine here. This doesn't have to be named like this. I'd much rather have it like Ghost Engine. Okay, I did not have it. I don't have a typo there. So, as I said, when I'm working on a feature, I like to have a branch. Let me create a feature branch. Let's call it project off. What am I missing here? Ah, yes, indeed, because I renamed this, I need to reopen the repository. Projects, Ghost Engine, open, add the feature branch, project, kickoff. Perfect. So, let's create the Rust project. At the moment, how I see this, it's similar with what Cerno is doing for its for his project. I don't know why I keep using it instead of his. I'm nervous. anyway, let's go to the Ghost Engine folder. So, as I said, I'm taking this from the Chernos playbook. I will create a project for the engine itself, and the project the engine will be a library. The second project will be a binary, and it will be sandbox binary, a place where we can prototype stuff and see how an end user would use it. And those two projects will be placed in a Rust workspace for easier builds, checks, tests, and so on. So, cargo. I'm creating a library, let's call it Ghost Engine. Or maybe just engine. No, let's go with the full name, Ghost Engine. Perfect, I have the library. Now the binary. And Ghost Sandbox. Ghost Sandbox. Okay. That's all for the binary. Now to create the workspace, I'll just open the project in Sublime. Oh no, what am I doing? Open folder, projects Ghost Engine, open, perfect. Now in the root folder, I'll create a new file. I will call it cargo.toml. I don't know how to pronounce it. This file extension, I like to call it toml. Save. And the format of this file is something like this. Workspace members. It's an array, this one, and here we have an array of strings, and each string it's the relative path to the folder to another Rust project. So to include those two Rust projects, Ghost Sandbox and Ghost Engine, in this workspace, we need to put here something like this, Ghost Engine and Ghost, not Engine, but Sandbox. Perfect, save. And now let's check that everything it's all right. We check that with cargo check. Okay, that's great. Build. And if we are running a cargo test command. Okay, no problems are detected. Okay. So we created those two projects. We also need to do some tidy ups. As you can see here in Git, we have a bunch of files under this directory target. We need to put this directory in the gitignore at the root. But More than that, we want to not just ignore this target directory, but any target directory that may live also under a particular project. Okay, so a new file, save it, dot git ignore. To specify a target folder that it may live also in the root directory or under the projects directory, we do like this: ** slash target get, and I think that's it. As you can see, Sublime already tells us it is ignored. You can double check here in Git. Yes, perfect. Okay, so we finished setting up git ignore, but there is also discussion about those files called cargo lock. I won't go into many details about what those files are containing. All we need to know is that for library projects, those files should be ignored. For binaries, they should be included in the repository. Now, the thing is, at the moment, I really don't know what the policy is for cargo lock files located in a workspace root directory. For the moment, I'll ignore it. This one from the root, and I also, for good measure, ignore what may appear. No, forget about it. We leave it like this. We will take care of anything strange in the future when the time comes. Let's stage our changes, commit them, and push them to GitHub. So, stage everything, project, kickoff. Okay, commit. Finishing the feature branch. I'm pushing to GitHub. Perfect, great. So let's double check. Let's go back to GitHub. Let's refresh. I always like to refresh. So we have two branches. Develop is here. Now the thing is that I see the default branch to be developed. My reasoning for that it's because all the pull requests and features are merged in develop. So to set develop branch as the default branch on GitHub, let's dig into the settings page of our project, and we should go here to branches. Okay, can see, just edit this. Put here develop. What already exists? Okay, this one is names the branch and this one switches the branch. Okay. Update. Yes, I understand. Go away. Okay, let's check again. Okay, by default, we go to develop. And as you can see, the project kickoff was pushed around 2 minutes ago. So that's everything related to setting up the project. Now I want to discuss a little bit about some requirements, not libraries and stuff like that. Requirements for you as someone interested in this series. I'm expecting you to have some programming knowledge. You went through some Hello Worlds. Maybe you are a, let's say, Java programmer with years of experience, but never touched Rust or graphics programming. For myself, I'm not an expert in Rust. I'm actually learning Rust while developing this. Also, I'm not a graphics programmer. I'm learning graphics programming while working on the Ghost Engine. But as long as you are open to what may lay ahead, bumps in the road, walls to climb, uncertainty, I think it will be a great thing to look forward to. If you spot that I'm doing some mistakes, let me know. I want to learn from you. And also, on the other hand, I would like to see you learning something from me. That being said, bye bye, and see you in the next episode.